Hi guys, hope you're well. So this is my go-to full coverage daytime look. If it's a lot of makeup for you, you can skip some steps, but I hope you enjoy this video. Using the strobe cream as a moisturizer, and it also illuminates the skin, so I'm putting it everywhere on my face. Because I have textured skin, I'm going to be using a smoothing primer. While applying the primer, I usually push it in the skin like that rather than dragging it out. It just helps the foundation to stick to the base. So I filled in my eyebrows beforehand. I'm gonna use the Soft Ochre paint pot and put it all over my eyelids. It creates a blank canvas for my eyeshadows that I'll be doing later on. I use any kind of translucent powder or any bone colored shadow to set all that in. Now I'm going to move on to correcting my skin, so I'm going to be using salmon orange color because I have really dark under eyes. I'm going to be placing that all through the areas of my face which are dark and going to be blending it with the concealer brush. Using a very damp beauty blender, I'm going to be blending out the edges so they don't look too harsh, and then I'm going to take this NARS concealer in ginger and place it on top of some scars. Then using the beauty blender again, I'm going to be pushing the product in rather than dragging it. Sorry, I didn't record the part where I was mixing two foundations, but basically they're Giorgio Armani Luminous Silk and Maybelline Fit Me. I feel like I'm always mixing foundations according to the tan I have, or it's just the mood I'm in. I'm placing the product with a brush and then I'm gonna be buffing it all out and taking the excess out with my damp beauty blender. Now I'm gonna be taking the NARS Creamy Concealer in Custard and putting that on my forehead, on the bridge of my nose, a little bit on the cupid's bow, maybe on the chin sometimes, and then around just under my eyes but not directly. I'm going to be using another color which is a little bit warmer. That's ginger, I believe. Yeah, so I'm going to be mixing that and blending it all again with a beauty blender. To avoid creasing under your eyes, I usually look up to the mirror and then blend out my concealer and push a translucent powder right after, because you don't want to wait, you just want to set it all in. This is a really good technique if you want your concealer to stay on all day. I'm just using the excess amount on my face, but I'm not going to be setting my entire face. Now we're gonna do some cream contouring. So I'm gonna take a flat brush like that, placing it on areas where there is naturally occurring shadows. Now take a buffing brush and push the product in, don't drag it a lot. Now taking a really fluffy fan brush, can't even say that right, you gotta set that contour. I know contouring can be messy, but you can always clean it up with a little bit of translucent powder. Just place it below your contour. For my nose contour, I'm gonna be using a little flat brush like this and drawing two lines along sides of the nose and then buffing it out with the same brush. Hold up! We're going to use the Beauty Blender to blend that more. Alright, on to my favorite part is the highlight. I'm going to be using the Shimmer Strips from Physicians Formula, taking the lightest color. I'll be placing that in the middle of the contour we did. And also some on the Cupid's bow. And a little bit on the tip of your nose. Then I'm setting all my powders with Fix Plus right before we move on to highlight, because it just melts every powder together and makes it less cakey. Then I'll be taking a fan brush and placing the same highlight we used on the tip of our nose and putting it on all the high points of my face. And because it's a daytime look, I would like to buff that out with a beauty blender. So for blush, I'm gonna be using a matte soft pink blush and placing that on the apple of my cheek and a little bit on my nose so it looks like sun-kissed. And to give a bit of warmth to my face, I'm gonna be using my Give Me Sun and dusting it everywhere we use the contour. Now back to the eyes. I'm going to be lightly dusting a bone colored eyeshadow. I'm going to be using Morphe 350M palette. Taking this neutral brown, putting it as my transition color just above my crease, buffing it out really nicely. And then taking a little bit of a rusty orange shade, placing on top of that, just below, closer to the crease, buffing it out again with a really fluffy eyeshadow brush. For my lid color, I'm gonna be using a neutral light brown nude shade. To deepen my crease slightly more, I'm gonna be using a little bit of darker red and brown to cut the crease, sort of, and place it on the outer V as well. To highlight under my eyebrows and the inner corners, I'm going to be taking this really pretty eyeshadow by Napoleon Purdis. Because we're not going to do a crazy wing, we're just going to place some black or brown, whatever you prefer, some kind of eyeliner right on the lash line. It also makes your lashes appear fuller, and then buff it out with a small buffing brush. Now I'm gonna give my lashes a really good curl before putting on mascara. And you wanna make sure you wiggle your wand from the bottom of your lashes upwards. To balance the eyeshadow on top, I'm gonna be placing the same colored eyeshadow right beneath the lash line and smoke it out. Then I'm going to tight line both my upper and lower lashes. You can use either a brown or black liner. I'm going to be also putting mascara on my bottom lashes. We're then going to line our lips with a soft matte brown or anything that complements your lips, and also fill it in. I had a hard time choosing what lipstick to wear, but then I ended up picking a lipstick and not a liquid lipstick. And the most important step is to set your entire makeup so it wears for a longer time. And that's the finished makeup look. I hope you enjoyed this tutorial. Thank you so much for watching.